an ex-teacher found dead in her car. 11 News reporter Kai Reed was in Glen Burnie tonight, where friends and family gathered in her memory.
My mother was like a diamond in the rough. My mother, people like my mother don't come along. They come along like once in a lifetime to me.
Myra Kaysen's son, Orlando, stood tonight surrounded by hundreds of people touched in some way by the 63-year-old woman's life.
And Lord, there are so many answers that we seek.
Mourners prayed, sang, and wept for the retired Glen Burnie teacher described as selfless, dedicated, and determined to help whoever, whenever she could.
This is my story. This is my song.
My mother always told me, son, I got your back, no matter what. Until the day I leave, until the day you leave, I'm here for you.
It's just terrifying, and it just hurts to the bottom of our heart just to know someone would do something to such a nice, wonderful, loving woman as Myra.
The crowd stood in the same shopping center parking lot where police discovered Kaysen's body around 11 o'clock Friday morning. She was found shot in the chest inside her Suzuki Sidekick. According to police, she was last seen 3 hours earlier, leaving the Maryland Primary Care Physician's Office just a couple of miles away. They believe the killer was in the car with her and forced her to drive to the shopping center parking lot. The motive appears to be robbery.
Whoever did this, I don't know what tempt you to do what you did, but turn yourself in. We need closure. We need closure. And if you wanted anything from Myra, all you had to do was ask, and she would give it to you.
Police have no suspects in the case, and Crime Stoppers is offering a $2,000 reward.
Whoever did this, just come. Just come turn yourself in.
Myra Kaysen left behind her son and two grandchildren. Family members are still working to finalize her funeral arrangements. Reporting in Glen Burnie, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.